Good morning. Welcome to our online morning service for All Saints Day, the day in the year when we think about those who have lived the faith before us and are with us no longer, whose paths we follow and whose example inspires us. And tonight there is a service for All Souls, the day when we remember those whom we love and see no longer. Normally we'd have this service in person in one of our churches, of course, and invite people to join us, but we can't do that at the moment. So we're doing something at 5 o'clock on YouTube, and please do join in with us then. We'll be lighting a candle in memory of all those who we know about, and we'll be ringing the church bell at St. Chad's as well at 5 o'clock as those candles are lit in the online service. Tomorrow evening our Bible study on the Psalms resumes. If you want to join us at 7:30, it's on Zoom, and do get in touch if you need help with that. Next week is Remembrance Sunday. There will be no outdoor parade, but we will, of course, be remembering those who have given their lives in the service of peace. We come from scattered lives to meet with God. Let us recognize his presence with us in a moment of pause. As God's people we gather, let us worship him together. God of our days and years, we set this time apart for you. Form us in the likeness of Christ so that our lives may glorify you. Amen. Since we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, looking to Jesus in penitence and faith. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Your faithful servants bless your name and speak of the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. So may the God of all healing and forgiveness draw us to himself and cleanse us from all our sins, that we may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And the prayer for today. God of holiness, your glory is proclaimed in every age. As we rejoice in the faith of your saints, inspire us to follow their example with boldness and joy, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And a reading from the first of John's letters to the church. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Lord, open our eyes to see wonderful things out of your law. Amen. If you've ever been walking in the hills, then you know what it's like trying to find the right path. You might have a map and you might know where you're trying to get to. And sometimes the path is obvious, it's clear, it's well trodden, there's signposts, it's well marked, you can see the gates and the stiles, and it's quite straightforward following a path through the hills or through the fields, wherever you're going. But it's not always the case, especially as you get away from the well-trodden paths and the paths start to get fainter. It can be hard to see where they go if they're in rocks or rocky ground. If the grass is worn, that's one thing, but trying to spot the polished rocks where people have trodden can get quite tricky. And you can get tempted off onto a false path, a sheep trail or a goat path, where the sheep make a path, but it goes nowhere. And you find yourself a long way from where you want to be. Or there is no path. You can see we want to be on that road, or we want to get to that hill, or we want to get down to that point there. But we're here, and there is no path between us. And we don't know where. Either we don't know where the path is, or to get to the right place, we're going to have to go a very long way round. Usually that happens. So we need to get from here to there, and we've got a long way round. It's usually at the end of a walk, when you just want to get home and you've had enough, and the idea of having to go the long way around is difficult. And sometimes in those circumstances, you end up looking for new paths. Either you know that there isn't a path where you want to go and you want to get there. And in this country, of course, if it's access land, you can do that. If you're in Scotland, there's no law of trespass. You can go where you want to. But in the hills, in parts of this country, you can do the same. And you try and find a new path through. If you ever tried to do that, and you think, this looks like a route I can go here, I can see my way through, and you set off, and after a while it's overgrown and you're pushing through bushes, or it's a bit steeper than you thought, or you end up in a bog or a stream. It can be very hard, it can be very, very slow going, setting a new path. And also there's that sense of, if somebody sees us, what are they going to think? Are they going to think we're a trespasser, or are they going to think we're a bit daft, or they think we're lost? It can be quite embarrassing. Trying to find your way down that, down a hillside or something when you've missed your path. Not straightforward at all. And one of the things that happens when you've done that is you look back. And when you look back, you can see the path where you should have been, or you can see the easier route, or you can see where you've been. And seeing those paths as you look back can be a lot easier to do. So why am I talking about paths on All Saints Day? Well, I think there's something about the saints, when we think about the great figures of Christian history, that they're people who are pathfinders. They see a need for a new path that people need to follow, a new way through life. And they're the ones who set off to tread that new path. They see there's something wrong with society, an ethical issue that's a problem. There are people who are marginalized, who are being excluded, or living in poverty or disease. And they're the people who decide that they're going to do something about it and try and change the world and set a new path for people to follow. People have done that on all sorts of things through Christian history. When you read the story of the people who worked in the slums in 19th century England, when they saw the misery that people lived in and they went to try and change society and change their lives. Those who fought to end slavery and to defeat the evil that was enslavement of people and transportation, they saw a new path, a need for it, and the fight was hard and difficult, particularly hard, of course, for those black, African and British and American people who campaigned, suffering the prejudice as well as the institutional nature of slavery. But they still saw the need for that new path, and they went off to try and set it up. And when we look back, some of those paths we see are obvious. How could anyone argue for slavery using the Christian gospel for so long? And yet people did. But we look back and we can see where the right path should have been, and we see how wrong they got it. And in one sense, that's one type of saint, those who have seen that need for a new path and have set off to create it for the rest of us to follow. But of course, there's the other type of saint as well, those who follow faithfully the right path. They don't take shortcuts. They don't wander off, like going for a long walk and wander off into the pub and get distracted and stay there for the afternoon instead of on your journey. Those who just follow faithfully day after day, week after week, year after year, following in the way that Jesus taught, without compromising, Of course, we all get it wrong. We all put a foot wrong and tread in a cow pat or something as we make our way across the fields. We all do that. But the saints, when we think about them, I think there's two things we think about then. In one sense, there's those who set the new paths, who see the way for a new route for us to follow. And of course, like any good path, it's not the first person who sets it up for the rest of us. It's the people who followed then and wear the path down and wear the path down so we can see where they've stepped and we can follow ourselves. So as a church, we remember all those who have gone before us, who've laid down the paths that we follow, following the way that Jesus taught, the way that leads to righteousness. Jesus talked about it as a narrow path, a narrow way. Broad is the way that leads to destruction, but narrow the way that leads to salvation. It can be hard following the path of the saints. Sometimes to get to the right place, they don't pay attention to whether it's an easy route or not. But then we are called as Christians to follow in their footsteps, to follow in the way that Jesus taught, and to seek to live this life that they showed us. Amen.
Never failing, let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior, the hope of nations. So Savior, Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save, He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Mighty to save, forever. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. We sing, Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever, author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the
grave. Just spend a few moments now in prayer. So united in the company of all the faithful and looking for the coming of the kingdom, let us offer our prayers to God, the source of all life and holiness. Merciful Lord, strengthen all Christian people by your Holy Spirit, that we may live as a royal priesthood and a holy nation to the praise of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless Paul and Bev, our bishops, and all ministers of your church, that by faithful proclamation of your word, we may be built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Empower us by the gift of your holy and life-giving Spirit, that we may be transformed into the likeness of Christ from glory to glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give to the world and its peoples the peace that comes from above, that they may find Christ's way of freedom and life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hold in your embrace all who witness to your love in the service of the poor and needy, all who minister to the sick and dying, and all who bring light to those in darkness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Touch and heal all those whose lives are scarred by sin or disfigured by pain, that raised from death to life in Christ, their sorrow may be turned to eternal joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remember in your mercy all those gone before us who have been well pleasing to you from eternity. Preserve in your faith your servants on earth. Guide us to your kingdom and grant us your peace at all times. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hasten the day when many will come from east and west, from north and south, and sit at table in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for the whole company of your saints in glory, with whom in fellowship we join our prayers and praises. By your grace, may we, like them, be made perfect in your love. Blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honour and power be to our God for ever and ever. Amen. So with saints and martyrs through the ages, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So may God, who kindled the fire of his love in the hearts of the saints, pour upon us the riches of his grace. Amen. May he give us joy in their fellowship and a share in their praises. Amen. May he strengthen us to follow them in the way of holiness and to come to the full radiance of glory. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen.